Welcome. This is the third lecture for the subject hydrology and water resources. So, in today's lecture, we will study two topics. First is difference between forecast and predict. Second is transport theory. So, what is difference between forecast and predict? So, let us see this. This is a little important, and usually some students do not differentiate these two words. They think both are same, but there is significant difference between these two words. Okay. So, what is the difference? So, see here the definition, that forecast is based on some facts, okay, based on some facts and some scientific logic, whereas prediction is not like that. Prediction is something based on somebody's personal experience or personal gut feeling. Okay, so how to understand this? For example, let us say there are two teams, India versus Australia. Okay, there are two teams, India and Australia. They are playing cricket match. Okay, and three matches are played, and out of these three, India won two matches, Australia won one match. Okay. Now, if somebody want to say what will happen in the fourth match, who will win fourth match? Okay. So this is the question: who will win fourth match? So there are two persons: person A and person B. So, person B says that Australia will win because he says Australia is a strong team, it will give strong comeback. Okay. So, based on his logic, his personal experience, he is saying that Australia will win. Whereas, the person A says that in every three match, India wins two match. So he says chances of India winning fourth match is 2/3, which is 66.67%. So person A says that chances of winning of India is 66.67%, which is greater than 50%, thus India should win. Okay? Whereas the person B says Australia will win. Okay? So what is the difference here? The difference is the person B's statement do not have any scientific logic or some fact. So this person is basically predicting. Okay. This person is doing prediction. Okay. Whereas this person A statement is based on this fact. So this person A is forecasting. Okay? So person A is forecasting. So this is the basic difference. Okay? One is forecasting something, one is just predicting something. Okay? So what is the use of this? Now if we want to know whether there will be rainfall or not, So we cannot predict anything. Okay, we have to forecast. Okay, so for forecasting, we need some data. Okay, so whatever a hydrologist will say about any instance or any process in the hydrological cycle, he should forecast that phenomena. Okay, so this is the basic difference. Moving ahead, next is transport theorem. What is transport theorem? What is transport theorem? Suppose water is moving in the atmosphere or in the river or in the lake or in the canal. Water is moving, okay? Now, if one person asks few questions, what are the questions? For example, he want to know that how water flows in the system, okay? How water flows? And he again asked, what happens to the properties of water when it flows? Okay. Then he again asked, how does the water carry his property while flowing? Okay. Another question can be, how to write a model for water flow? Basically, model, what is model? Model is basically formula. Both have same meaning. Model and formula are basically the same word. These days people prefer the word model, okay, instead of formula. So if somebody have this question in his mind, that how, what happens to water for these statement, and he wants some answer, okay, so how to answer such questions? You need some mathematical justification or some mathematical model. So to answer such questions, you need to derive some mathematical formula or some theorem. Okay. Now what we are doing, we are trying to derive this theorem. Okay. This theorem will give answer to these questions. Okay. So before we start, we must, before start starting of derivation, we must make some concept, okay? Or we must have some preliminary knowledge about how to make or how to derive formula, okay, or how to make one model. So look at this slide. So suppose there is some system. What is system? System means there is some process. So collection of all the process will be called system. For example, what can be the process? Process can be precipitation. Precipitation means rainfall, or runoff, or evaporation, or infiltration. Okay. There can be many process. So collection of all the process will be called system. Now we want to make one model or formula for this system. Okay. How can you make? So when we in an attempt to make one model, we observe that we can make two type of model or two type of formula. First type is called deterministic model. Another is called stochastic model. What is deterministic model? So, deterministic model means if you make some formula and it gives answer exactly correct, okay, it is exactly what happens in the reality, okay, then it will be called deterministic model, okay. So, and other will be stochastic model. So if you want to make one model, what can you incorporate in the model? So let us see like this. Suppose water is flowing. Now you want to make formula. So what you want to check in the formula, or what you want in the formula, you want that how property of water changes with respect to time. Okay, so in deterministic model there should be time. Then you want to know if water moves along a space or along in any direction, then what happens to the property. So you want to incorporate space also. Space means xyz coordinates. Okay, so you want these things. Okay, so deterministic model uses time, space and other properties of and what happens in stochastic model. So see, stochastic model will have time, will have space, but it also has some uncertainty. Okay, uncertainty means probability means randomness. Okay, so uncertainty is involved, or randomness is involved. Okay, there is what does it mean. So if you will make a stochastic model or formula, when question will be asked will it rain or not, then you will say okay there is 66% chances of rainfall. Whereas if you will answer through deterministic model, you will say okay there will be rainfall. Okay, 100% correct, 100% you can determine, but you cannot determine 100%. There is involvement of some uncertainty, then it will be called stochastic. Okay, further both type of model can be broken into two parts, lump distributed. So what does this means? Lump means it is basically means lump. Okay, lump ka matlab kya hota hai, ek jagah ho jana, like a point. So formula will be lump means at a point you will be calculating something. Okay, for example you will calculate at this point what will be the temperature, what will be the energy. Okay, so at one point you are talking. Another kind of distributed means there will be x, y, z or space. So you will be talking over a certain space, not at a point. Okay, so both can be useful for us. Okay, for now if you will observe that in the atmosphere or in the earth there can be million and crores and infinite number of points. So it will be very difficult to study all the points. So this type of model should not be used for forecasting something. Whereas distributed model, you want to study certain space which is practically possible. So we can take distributed model in that requirement. Similarly, stochastic model also have lump and distributed. Also, every model can also be broken in terms of time. Okay, whether they involve time or not. So if they involve, if they do not take time, then it is called steady flow. Steady model. If they take time, then it will called unsteady model. Okay. So basically, what you are doing, you are taking space as a point, and then you are taking full space. Then you are taking time, and then you are not taking time. So similarly, for distributed also, there will be steady, unsteady. For here also steady, unsteady. For here also steady, unsteady. So like that, it can make. So you can make various types of model. Okay, depending on what kind of model you want to make. Okay. Let us come back. Let us come back. We were talking about transport here. So we will try to derive this transport theorem. So let us try to derive. So let us say that there is some space or some lake or some canal, okay, in which water is flowing. Okay. Now you cannot study all the states. You need to fix some volume. Okay. You cannot study all the length of river or canal or any system. So what you are required to do? You will restrict yourself to limited volume. Suppose I will say that I will study only this portion of canal or river or any space. Okay. I want to study only this much of the space. Only this much of the volume. Okay. So when you decide that this type of volume that you are studying is called control volume. What is control volume? Volume under observation. Volume under observation. Okay. So you want to study this one. So then you can also observe that for this volume, water enters from here, and in this section, water enters. So this section is called inflow, and water leaves the controlled volume through this section. So this will be called outflow. Outflow fraction, inflow fraction. Okay. So water will enter from this inflow section, water will leave control volume from outflow section. Okay. So let us say water enters the inflow from inflow section into the control volume. Okay, and it has some property. Okay. So let's derive this. Let water enters in control volume from inflow section. It have some extensive property B. So water enters the control volume and water have some extensive property B. Okay. He enters in the system and then he leaves from the outflow section. Okay. So what is extensive property? So let's move to another page. So what is extensive property? What is the extensive property? So you can recall your knowledge from thermodynamics. Extensive property is property that depends on mass. What can be other property? Other property is called intrinsic property. Which is independent of mass. So there are two types of property: extensive property and intrinsic property. So let extensive property is called B, let intensive property is called beta. So what is the relation? Independent of mass. So beta can be written as d by dm of B. Okay? Independent of mass is beta. So again you can write it as dB is equal to beta dot dm, m for mass, beta for intrinsic property. Okay. Now if you will integrate this, what will you get? Beta is equal to integration over dm. Now you should observe that where are our properties? We are studying properties inside the controlled volume. Okay. So for integration also we should be integrating for volume or for triple integration. So it will be written as beta dot dm. We are doing for what? Volume. So we need to change this mass into volume. So you remember that how it can be changed? You can use this concept that density is equal to mass divided by volume. Mass is equal to density into volume. From this concept you can replace dm in terms of volume. So replace it rho dot dv. I am writing volume by a cut. Okay. So in this way you can express extensive property in terms of intrinsic property. Okay. Okay. Moving ahead. So again you want to come back here. Let us say at any time t water is inside the controlled volume, and after the passage of some time delta t, what happens? Water inside this will move out of this outflow section. Okay. So let us write here that water will move something like this. Okay, the water inside will shift, will move out. So now you can see here are three part: part 1, part 2, part 3. Okay, you should remember that part 3 is outside the controlled volume. It is not inside the controlled volume. Okay, so what we are doing, that we observe that what is the status of properties at any time. So property at any time t, okay, what are the properties? Let's come back here. So at any time t, which is initial condition, property is at portion 1 and portion 2. After time t, properties are at 2 and 3. Initially, property is at 1 and 2. After some time, water moves out and property will remain at section 2, at portion 2 and portion 3. So, at any time, the property is at, property is in section 1 or portion 1 at any time t, plus property is in the section 2 at any time. Then after the passage of some time delta t, let us write again, property at time t plus delta t. After passage of some time, what will be the property? Property in the second portion, that will be at t plus delta t time, plus property in the third portion at the time d plus delta t. Okay? So, you have calculated property at any time t, initial condition, then final condition. Now, what you want? You want to see that how properties changes with respect to time. Okay? How property changes with respect to time. Okay? So, you have to write its derivative with respect to time. So, here, let us write it in terms of limit. Let us write in terms of limit where delta t is very small. So, how to write is 1 upon delta t. Okay. Then, what it will be here? Difference of the properties at t plus delta t and t initial and final and initial condition, the difference. Let's write it here. Final condition, what is 2 t plus delta t, okay, plus property in the third portion at time t plus delta t, difference, okay, final condition minus initial condition, property in the first portion at time t plus property in the second portion at time t. So here you have written it in terms of limit. Okay. Now you see that in this portion also it is second term. Here also it is second term. So we can rearrange this. Okay. So let us rearrange. Okay. Let us rearrange this. So dv by dt can be written as limit delta t tends to 0, 1 upon delta t. Let us rearrange property b at any time, property in the section 2 at any time t plus delta t minus property in the second portion at any time t. Okay. Then property in the first portion at, sorry, in the third portion at time t plus delta t, okay, minus property in the first portion at time t. Okay, so you have rearranged it. Okay. After rearranging, you should observe something. What you should observe, let us go back to initial condition, that section 2 or the portion 2 is inside the control volume, okay, before also and after also, okay, whereas section 1 and section 3, okay, what does they represent? That this inflow is from this portion, some inflow is there with respect to inflow section. Similarly, there is some outflow with respect to control volume. Okay. What does this mean? Let us write it here. That what does this represent? That section 2 is is basically property stored in control volume, whereas property 1 and property 3, what do they represent? They represent inflow and outflow. Outflow from control section. What are control section? Inflow section and outflow section. Okay. So this represent stored property. This represent your inflow and outflow. Okay. So if you want to convert this, this is stored in the volume. Okay. So again we will write this. So let us convert this limit in terms of integration. Okay. So how it can be written? Limit delta t tends to 0. Now 1 by delta t will convert into d by dt. Okay. For this property, okay, for this property we have done some work. So see from here how B can be written in terms of intrinsic property. Okay. So we will put it here. Okay. So how will we write it? As triple integration of beta dot rho dot, what is d volume. Triple integration is over control volume. Then for another portion, this cannot be integrated in terms of volume. Why? Because it is not stored in the control volume. It is some inflow and outflow. So we have to integrate it in terms of area. So let us do that also. Limit delta t tends to 0, 1 upon delta t. Okay. So this is like triple integration beta dot rho dot d. Okay. But we cannot write it in terms of volume. So we have to convert it in terms of area. So convert it in terms of area. How will you convert? Volume is equal to some delta L into dA. dA represents some area. Okay. So we can write it like this. We are okay. So let's write it here. Okay. So then you can further observe that what you can do here, you can bring this delta t here. Okay, you can bring that delta t here. This is integration. Sorry, we have to remove this because we are doing with respect to area, so double integration is required. So what is this? Delta L divided by delta T. Length upon time is nothing but velocity. So it can be written in terms of, this is basically velocity. So now you can see that here I have used crossed V for volume, simple V for velocity. Okay. So again we will write this. Let us remove the limit and it will be like d by dt triple integration over controlled volume beta dot rho dot dv. Okay. Plus let us remove the limit, it will be double integration beta over rho, this will convert into velocity dot. So this is our final equation. Okay. Now this equation was first derived by Reynolds. Thus this equation is also called Reynolds transport theorem. So you will observe that this Reynolds transport theorem will become the base of hydrology. Why it will become? Because you are talking about any property B. Okay, any property B. Property can be anything. So you can derive many other equations from Reynolds transport theorem. Okay, we will do it in the next class. Okay, thank you very much. This is all for today's class.